Hey guys, how you doing? This is Mangbet Section. I'm here today to bring the review for Shaman King, episode number 12. So we're going on the flow, like, you know, like we kind of skip forward a little bit because if I remember correctly, when we last leave off with Yo and Ren, they're running towards, you know, going to find Ryu and Trey and just, you know, take down Ren's dad at the end of the day. They're heading towards that, and at the beginning of this episode we have skipped to there where they basically, no, actually that's a lie, because after they defeat Mr. Red, as I'm gonna call him, they go on a little bit further to tell his dad. But there is a little bit of a jump, you can see that for yourself mainly. But what I want to talk about first is, you know, we had the Super Sentai of Tao, you know, the Power Rangers of Tao, Super Sentai Tao and Power Rangers Tao, we had that squad, yeah. And as we know, Ryu and Trey took out four or five, yeah, we know this, yeah. So we're left with Red, and basically we find out as the episode goes on that this is Pyron's master, yeah, fair enough, cool, there's no problems with that, I have no qualms with that, yeah. And the whole thing here is students surpassing the master, yeah, I'm cool with that. I get the cliche, it's been done many times before, but more time, if not all the time, it's usually because the master has gotten old. And now this is where my problem starts to come within what happens within this episode. And now I'm not comparing it to the original anime like I usually do, because I have not rewatched the episode where this would be, you know, related to. I'm just giving you my thoughts and opinions this time on simply how I would like things to be done and what I think makes for a more realistic story. So within the contents of this episode for the 2021 anime, we are told that this is Pyron's master. We are also told that not just this Sentai warrior, the zombies basically, yeah, we were told that all of the zombies have been modified, so they're big and bad and, you know, powerful zombies, yeah. So the way I see it, yeah, is that we have a prime Pyron's master here, yeah, a prime, something equivalent to what would have been like in his prime, yeah. Pyron's master, I forget his name, I think his name is Shaman. So we have a prime, if his name was Shaman, we have a prime Shaman versus, I guess, a prime Pyron, yeah. And we don't get much of a fight, and it's because of those, in fact I think it was just one shot, I think Pyron defeats him on one shot, and it's because of that I'm like, really? All the hype for, you know, modified zombies, you know, bigger and bad, and then we find out, you know, that this one in particular has the spirit of Pyron's master. We find it's told to us within this episode as well, and I do believe it's told to us before when, you know, we had Shaman before, that the only person that can beat Pyron is his master. So when we have all of that, when we take all of that in consideration, and then we have Pyron quickly one-shot him within this episode, it's a bit of like a, really, is that really, really realistic? What I would have liked for this episode is to have a bit more of a drawn out fight, just to make it more realistic, and therefore I can say, okay, Pyron had to overcome and endure to beat his master within this episode, possibly showing his growth as well. But we don't get that, we get a one shot. Okay, fair enough. So after that, they head over to fighting Tao, Ren's dad. And they are fighting, they're having a hard time. We find out that this big body that we've seen of Tao is his oversoul. They figure that out for themselves. And therefore, we then have Ren overcome his dad. I'm not going to say defeat, because at the end of the day, like, you know, if this was a shaman battle, Team Yo versus Ren, then, you know, the battle would still be ongoing, because it's basically just told to us that Tao's Furioku pool is just ridiculous, and I think at the end of the damn day, Tao would have come out on top. But this wasn't about that. This wasn't why Ren was here in the first place. He was here to like repent for his sins and just like clear his mind, so all of this wasn't hanging over him once he's going forward within the Shaman King tournament. And he came here to do that, and that's essentially what he achieved. He got his the W that he needs. Yes, he was trying to brag and say, the fight continued, that or the other or the or the, or the yeah, but we know the truth at the end of the day, and he did what he came here to achieve, and that was good. And we have that whole thing where the granddad and the grand and the granddad and Ren's mother come like, oh yeah, food, the party, it's a long time since Ren's come home. Oh, Ren's got friends now, that's cool, kind of thing. We had that whole kind of vibe there. Don't remember that at all, but I'm probably just forgetting that. But during this time, we have that whole speech of good and evil, there's a gray area in there, there's like, it's hard to differentiate between the two. But we also find out that, Tao wasn't trying to be evil. He just kind of wavered off the path a little bit, basically just told that there. And then, yeah, that's it. Like, Ren came here to do what he's gonna do. He's ready for the Shaman King tournament. He heads off. And up until now, Tao was in a mindset of his own, and he's like, yo, like, if my children can't follow my mindset, then I'm done with my children, kind of thing. But we see that throughout his experience with Ren and Jun as well, I guess, within the last couple of episodes, that he's come around to their way of thinking, and you're seeing things their way. And the way that you the reason why you know that this is a fact is because when Ren was leaving, Tao's dad not only came to Tao's dad Ren's dad Tao not only came to see not only came to see off Ren, but he also gave him his sword, saying like, just passing the mantle, kind of thing, saying like, yo, like, take this, I believe in you, son, go win that tournament, kind of vibe. And that's where we leave off the episode. So I guess my only problem with this episode is the whole Pyron versus his master thing. Like, if they fixed that up, it would have been pretty damn good. Obviously, they could always do more to extend the fights and make it more exciting. I actually had a comment on, I think it was my last episode review, where he mentioned that how the fights in the series are not really like flashy like the typical shonen fight, and they're really more about just like overcoming and winning with revenge, kind of thing. And I agree with that, but let's mix it up, and we can have both, and it could be excellent. But I'm going to give this episode a 3-star rating and call it a review. Like always, guys, I'm asking for your thoughts and opinions. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. But most importantly, take care. Have a nice day.